Everybody loves a sequel, especially when it comes to the world's most comfortable shoe. Introducing the Allbirds Wool Runner 2, a next-level revamp of the cult classic. 7 years in the making, it's been completely reimagined for a game-changing fit and feel. With enhanced cushioning and super soft materials, the Wool Runner 2 delivers comfy all-day wear built for bliss. Visit Allbirds.com and use code FRESH24 to score a free pair of socks with purchase. That's Allbirds.com, code FRESH24.
You're listening to a Weeby Geeks Network podcast.
It's the Neverland Podcast, episode 112.
This holiday season, the Walt Disney Studios proudly presents our 31st all-new full-length animated motion picture, Aladdin. It's the most exciting magic carpet ride ever. A musical journey of mystery and wonder.
It's all so magical.
With Aladdin, his magic lamp, and some wonderful new friends.
Wow.
Princess Jasmine, Abu the monkey, Iago the parrot, Jafar the treacherous villain.
Bring me the lamp.
And a very powerful, very special
genie of the lamp.
Right here, direct from the lamp.
Don't miss Disney's all-new musical entertainment event. With 6 new songs from the Academy Award-winning composer of The Little Mermaid and Beauty and the Beast.
You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend.
Walt Disney Pictures presents Aladdin.
You ain't never had a friend like me.
Welcome back to the Neverland Podcast. I hope you got your pixie in your pocket. Make sure you take that pixie out of your pocket, sprinkle some of that pixie dust around, and get ready to fly with me. Well, of course, by flying with me, I'm referring to flying with pixie dust, not on a magic carpet. Although we're going to take a magic carpet ride later, as we're going to hear one of the final performances from Aladdin, the musical spectacular from Disney's California Adventure, as recorded by Lost Boy Eric. This isn't the exact final show, but it's probably the final time that Eric ever got to see the show. And so he's recorded the audio and shared it with us, and so we're going to listen to that. But before we do that, I do have a review of the Tom Amin album Journey to the Stars. Now, this, of course, is where he was doing covers of Star Wars songs, and I finally got my copy in the mail over a month later after I ordered it when he released it. You might remember that Tom Amin was a guest on our show. Oh, I guess it's been about a month ago. But go back and listen to that. Talk to him the weekend before his new album came out, and he is currently looking to get ideas of what he might do for his next album, and he's presented a couple of choices on Facebook. He's considering doing a video games album. Or I think the other one, he wanted to do some more Disney movies, something outside the park. Go check up on his website, Tom Amin Music and everything, and he might still be, you know, seeing what everybody's opinion is. I'd kind of like to hear him do some video game music, because that would be very unique and different, and I'd like to hear it. We're also going to take a visit to the trailer park, because there was a new trailer that premiered this week during the, well, CW's DC television entire block this week, with DC's Legend of Tomorrow, and then of course they were, you know, Dawn of the Justice League and that kind of thing, premiering all the stuff's coming in the movie, or previewing it really, and they showed a trailer that I will be sharing here in the trailer park. But enough of this chit-chat, let's get right to it with a review of Tom Amin's A Journey to the Stars. Now, needless to say, I was very excited for this album. I do own some Tom Amin music, where he's done arrangements of some Disney Parks music, and it's very, very good. He's very talented, and it's very relaxing to listen to. It's familiar tunes, but you get to hear them in a new way, and this is definitely no exception. These are songs you're going to recognize. Of course, it's got the Star Wars main theme, which there was so much he could do with it that he actually has two different versions of it at the beginning and at the end of the album. He has a reprise of it and still is doing something different with it. So you're hearing it, the melody will be familiar to you, but what he does with it and the style he plays it in, well, is a little bit different. So it's a unique sound. One of my favorite ones, actually this very second track, Cantina Band. it's kind of a ragtime style. At least that's what it sounded like to me, and I very much enjoyed it. Take a listen. Other highlights in here, my goodness, what he did with the Imperial March, wow, it's, he, you know, he starts strong with it, but then he kind of backs it away and just plays the melody, and it has an eerie quality to it, the way he's presenting it, and of course he does come in with bringing in a strong march and a fearsome We Are the Empire, but he gets you to look at it in a slightly different perspective. I also really enjoy what he did with Duel of the Fates. Now, this piece, really, which I had not really thought of before, but if you've been listening to the Star Wars Oxygen program with Rebel Force Radio and David Collins, he talked about Duel of the Fates as being literally as if you have two possible fates for Anakin Skywalker that were battling each other. And anytime you hear this music, there's something happening that is Anakin could have gone to the light side and stayed there, or have, you know, become Darth Vader. And so this piece takes on a note of tragedy, because if you go back and watch the prequels, I mean, the first time you hear it is, of course, the duel going on between Darth Maul, Qui-Gon Jinn, and Obi-Wan Kenobi. And who's to say what would have happened if Qui-Gon Jinn had survived? Maybe Qui-Gon Jinn would have been a better teacher than Obi-Wan. And maybe Anakin would not have gone to the dark side. We won't know. So it's almost like there's a fate in there. The next time it really becomes prominent is in Episode 2, when we see Anakin going off to find his mother. And, you know, if his mother had been okay, if he'd have managed to rescue her and bring her back home safe and sound, it could have been a very different, you know, person. Because he made a huge leap to the dark side at that point. So, you know, this piece really does come up every time Anakin is being slowly drawn to the dark side. And Tom Amin really brings out the tragedy in this piece, just somehow in the tone of it. There's this tension that he's managed to bring to it that, well, it's definitely there in the original John Williams music, but I don't know, hearing the way Tom Amin has played it just seemed to bring that all to the surface for me. And it was really, really awesome. There is a somewhat original, but not quite original piece called May the Force Be With You on here. It's basically the Force theme, also known as Obi-Wan's theme to a lot of people. But there isn't a concert piece, and most of the pieces on here are concert pieces of some sort. But there is no concert piece of the Force theme, so he basically kind of creates one. And it is beautifully played, it is wonderful, he's done a great job, he's taken bits from various parts of the movie where you will recognize the theme kind of playing in the background, you know, as setting up the scene. And he seems to have put them together, and it's really, really cool. But of course, you do hear that come back again with a big, bold throne room theme, where he, of course, you know, the main thing is this anthem of the Force theme and the Rebel theme. Very, very wonderful piece of music. He's just done great things with it. He's played the original Ewok celebration from the Return of the Jedi, the original. And it's very... He slows it, you know, it's not as boisterous as it is, but it's just this nice, calming, happy, the way he's played it. It's really a very, I loved it as well. He also included the victory celebration from the special edition version and, you know, brought out the beauty in that. My goodness, the only thing he did not do was the Han and Leia theme. He didn't do anything with that, but maybe, you know, if this sells really well, maybe we can expect some more Star Wars music come out, and maybe the Han and Leia theme will come out, and then of course he'll have a lot more music from the new trilogy to play with at the time. He's also got a very nice original piece called Journey to the Stars, the title track. Now, when I heard this, it reminded me a little bit of Across the Stars there at the beginning, but he's done his own thing. I guess maybe he's encapsulating the Han and Leia theme and Across the Stars together, and creating his own love theme, pretty much, for the trilogy, and or the saga, rather. And then, of course, he's also got a waltz style, the Cantina Band, which sounds weird when you think about it, but when you hear it and you hear that waltz beat going on, and then he plays the Cantina Band to it, and It's really, really wonderful. I fully enjoyed this album. It's definitely worth your time to go and purchase. If you haven't picked it up already, I encourage you to go get a copy of it. And I'm going to, of course, have a link for you in the show notes where you can get your very own copy of this. It was a great, great album. I very enjoyed it. And I'm looking forward to what Tom Amin brings out next, be it video games or movie themes.
Another gator in the house.
Another gator?
Give me that shovel. Come here.
Get him all.
Get that gator.
The Neverland Trailer Park.
Is this the real life?
Let me out of here, Donald, please.
Let me out of here, brother.
Is this just fantasy?
Get on.
Caught in a landslide. No escape from reality.
I want to assemble a task force of the most dangerous people on the planet.
They're bad guys. Worst of the worst.
Too late.
Open the gate!
My time has come. Send shivers down my spine.
Was this cheerleading trials?
Hi, boys.
Goodbye, everybody.
Deadshot. Guy shoots people.
He's a crocodile.
And he eats people.
Burns people.
You're possessed by a witch,
and she's just crazy.
What was that? I should kill everyone and escape? Sorry. The voices. I'm kidding. That's not what they really said.
This is the deal. You're going somewhere very bad.
Whoa!
Do something that'll get you killed.
Let's go save the world.
I can't wait to show you my toys.
Mamma mia, mamma mia, mamma mia, let me go.
Let's do something fun.
Seriously, the hell's wrong with you people?
We're bad guys. It's what we do.
Nothing really matters to me.
All right, so this week's trailer is Suicide Squad, which after I watched this trailer and even heard the music choice and the way it's presented, I think I liked this movie better when it was called Guardians of the Galaxy. They've really borrowed from the ad campaign for Guardians of the Galaxy, and it seems a similar theme going on of being we are the rogues and we're trying to be heroes now. Suicide Squad isn't really about being heroes. They're basically trying to get out of their sentence, and they basically, well, you guys are expendable, so we're going to send you on this basically suicide mission, and if some of you died, we don't care. And if you survive it, well, hey, we've given you the incentive where we're going to let you go. It includes a few, you know, major known, lighter known type of DC villains. I mean, they might be more important to more DC fans. I'm more of a Marvel guy myself. But it has a group of them together. And I got to say, Harley Quinn, she doesn't really look like I'd expect. She's kind of, the character's overgone a lot of transformation. You know, when you could look at the Batman animated series where we were first introduced to Harley Quinn, that was where they created the character for. Had a drastic change in the Arkham games to more of a, well, sexpot type of character. It became a very different character as presented. I'm not sure what all they've done with her in the comics at this point, besides a little bit of comic relief. Anytime I've seen her or read any of her books, she's still comical. So I think she's comic relief apparently in this movie, but the look she has in here, it's, yeah, let's just say they're pushing that PG-13 with some stuff, you know. She's there to be eye candy, it looks like. And, you know, as far as playing the character, it looks like some of the things, you know, she's got the idea. Oh, we're going to kind of miss the kind of high-pitched voice that we're used to for Harley from Arlene Sorkin. So overall, I can't say that I'm really that interested in this movie. I really haven't ever been interested in this, and I have only seen the DC diehards who are just extolling that this is going to be great and wonderful, but I always think they're trying to convince themselves because they always have to also badmouth the Marvel movies and say how awful they were, and I think they're just jealous that Marvel hasn't got great movies coming out and has Disney behind them to make great Marvel movies. And DC has got Zack Snyder, and I've not really been that thrilled with what he's done. So yeah, that's the Suicide Squad trailer. I'm not really going to go into detail too much on it because I really can't get excited about it, but I figured I'd have to cover it to some degree because, well, I can't really talk about Deadpool because it's an R-rated movie type of thing coming around, and, well, we're trying to be a family-friendly show, so Deadpool, the way they're presenting that one, it's not very family-friendly, but I'm expecting that movie to be much more entertaining than Suicide Squad. So there's what we have for the trailer park this week. And now it's time to take a seat there in the old Hyperion Theater for one last time to listen, at least, to the audio to the Aladdin Musical Spectacular from Disney's California Adventures. Enjoy.
Whoa!
Flat and immense, and the heat is intense. It's barbaric, but hey, it's home. When the wind's from the east, and the sun's from the west, and the sand in the glass is right, come on down, stop on by, hop a carpet and fly to another Arabian night. Ooh. Ah, salam and good evening, weary travelers. Heading towards Agrabah, are you? Perhaps I should help you pass the time with a tale. The desert night hides a thousand stories.
Whoa!
The Cave of Wonders, the setting of one of our most famous legends, the Tale of the Magic Lamp.
Dares approach the Cave of Wonders. Diamond in the rough may enter. All else will perish.
You will fetch me that lamp. Now, go.
Oops!
That's the third peasant that cave's eaten this week. How will I ever become sultan without that lamp?
Blame, blame, blame. How many peasants do we have to go through before we get that stupid lamp?
Patience, Iago, patience. That peasant was obviously less than worthy.
Oh, there's a big surprise. I think I'm gonna have a heart attack from not surprise.
Silence!
Iago.
You have to find this diamond in the rough.
Yeah.
Where could he possibly be?
Hold you worthless street rat! Mr. Worthless Street Rat to you!
That boy's been stealing my apples again!
He's a public menace!
Guys, let's not do anything too drastic, okay? I mean, you wouldn't attack a guy just for stealing one old measly piece of fruit now, would you? I'll take that as a yes. Here, take it back. I didn't really want it anyway.
Hey, he's getting away!
That boy is such a nuisance.
They should put him in the royal dungeon and throw away the key.
Somebody, stop!
One jump,
ahead of the bread line. One swing ahead of the sword. I steal only what I can't afford. And that's everything. One jump ahead of the lawman. That's all, and that's no joke. These guys don't appreciate I'm broke.
Street rats!
Street rats!
It's a fact, that he's a friend or two.
Always have eyes in the bottom. He's become a black and rising crime.
I'm a head, except he hasn't got
him. Gotta eat to live, gotta steal to you. Tell you all about it when I got the time. One jump ahead of the slow folks. One skip ahead of my doom. Next time, gonna use a nom de plume. One jump ahead of the hitman, one hit ahead of the fly.
Hey!
I think I'll take a stroll around the block.
Stop it!
And go outwards!
Let's not be too hasty.
Still, I think he's rather tasty.
Gotta eat to live, gotta steal to eat. Otherwise, we get along. Maybe I'm not. Maybe it was an act of fate.
Thank you.
Hungry?
You stole that, no doubt.
Well, the way the Sultan taxes his people, we had no choice but to steal.
You always give away your stolen goods?
Only to those less fortunate. Or, in your case, the more beautiful. And you can't escape on an empty stomach.
What makes you think I'm trying to escape from something? Isn't that obvious?
Look. These streets can be dangerous. You'll need a guide. Hey, what's wrong? Don't you trust me?
You're very kind.
The name's Aladdin. Most people just call me
Street Rat!
Oh, come on, this way. Oh, run that way!
There's no sense in running for it. We've got you surrounded.
And it looks like he's got an accomplice.
Hey, leave her out of this. She didn't do anything. It was all my fault. She's innocent.
Silence, Street Rat!
Let it have me this instant! No! Stop calling him Street Rat. He's a person just like you and me.
Well, listen to the little vagabond. The way she's ordering us around, you'll think she was a princess of Agrabah herself!
I am the princess of Agrabah! Then I demand that you set this poor peasant free immediately, or I shall report all of you to the Sultan.
100 apologies, Your Majesty, but we were only following the law, and with all due respect, it is your father who makes the laws, not you, Your Highness.
That's right, Princess. I appreciate the effort.
You are to do nothing with him until I speak with my father. Don't worry, this will all be resolved before any harm comes to you. You're in my way.
1,000 pardons, Your Majesty! You may think you have friends in high places, boy, but no matter what the princess says, we're free to handle thieves as we see fit, right here on the streets!
No,
stop everything! Stop everything! Oh, there you are, my boy! Your mother and I have been so worried about you.
And you would be?
Play on, boy, unless you want to sleep with the prison mice tonight. Or worse. I'm the boy's father.
That's right. He's a boy's father.
He's always getting into trouble, this one. But he's a good boy. He has a true heart and a noble spirit. You can almost call him a diamond in the rough. Whatever it is he's stolen, I'm sure this would more than repay the debt.
You'll notice there are a few extra gold coins for all your hard work.
Well, seeing as the debt has been repaid, and then some, you are free to go, but don't let us catch you ever again.
Believe me, that's the plan.
Come on.
Well, that was easy enough.
Hey, why'd you help me out like that?
Just compassionate, I guess. Of course, one good deed deserves another.
I had a feeling there was a catch.
Who dares approach the Cave of Wonders? Only the diamond in the rough may enter. All else will perish.
I don't like those odds.
Don't worry about it. I consulted with an ancient oracle. You are the diamond in the rough.
Yeah, get inside.
Okay, I changed my mind about this.
It's neither them nor our tribute to the past gods. Go! Now! That is no time to waste. And whatever you do, at least touch the land.
There goes nothing.
He made it inside, you foulness!
It's only a matter of minutes now before all of Agrabah is calling me Sultan Jafar. Remember, only touch the lamp!
Got it! Only touch the lamp. Only touch the lamp. Only touch the lamp. Hello? Is anybody down there? Sure, it's dark in here. How did I get myself into this? I'm not so sure this is any better than the royal dungeon. All right, Aladdin, don't panic. One jump ahead of the lawman, one swing ahead of the sword. Better throw my hand in. Wish me happy landing. One trick ahead of disaster, one skip ahead of my doom. Look at all this gold! I'm gonna be rich! Alright, only touch the lamp. Only touch the lamp. Only touch the lamp! Whoa! Listen! I can assure you that was only an accident! Oh, great. Just great. Now how am I supposed to get out of here? Oh, this isn't fair. Hey, somebody! Somebody let me out of here! Somebody! Hey! Are you trying to get out of here too? I know exactly how you feel. The name's Aladdin. Well, this way looks blocked. Well, you got any other ideas? Where are you going? All that. I know, right? All this work for some measly piece of junk. What? I have no idea what you're trying to say. Does anybody out there speak carpet? What was that?
Yes!
Oh, you want me to rub the lamp? Okay. I'll give it a shot.
Oh.
Yeah!
Yeah, boy! You just got served! Hey! Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. You have no idea what it's like to be cramped inside that tiny little thing for the last 10,000 years, 22 hours, and 53 seconds! Wow, this place feels really empty. Is this Kim Kardashian's head? Dude, be like, turns honest with me? Do I have, like, super crazy lamp hair?
Who are you?
Oh, I'm a Smurf working on my dad bod. I'm a genie! But you know what that means, don't you? Oh, man. That means that you got three, count them, three wishes coming your way.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah! But before we get started, let's go over the rule book. Old sport. Rule number one, no wishing for more wishes. It's against genie labor laws. Union! Rule number two, I can't make someone fall in love with you. But honestly, bro, this whole no-shirt, open-vest thing you got going on really works for you. You have super sick abs, am I right? Oh! Rule number three, I can't raise the dead. But I can suspend you four games for illegally tampering with footballs, then unsuspend you because I think you're handsome. Hey! Carpet! Oh, long time no see. Hey, I was thinking about you. I really want to keep an eye on your thread count. It's a really big deal, okay?
Wait, let me get this straight. I'm your master. You're giving me three wishes?
That's what we genies do! That's what we genies do! I know. It sounds all hashtag blessed, right? But you have to spend your whole life trapped inside a lamp, doling out wish after wish after wish. No real freedom of your own. But what am I doing talking about me for? This sun is your lucky day, not mine. And you got no idea what's in store, friend! Well, lovely Papa had been 40 thieves. Shahab's eye had 1,000 tails. Master, you're in luck, cause up your sleeves. You got a friend, the magic never fails. You got some power in your corner now, some heavy ammunition in your camp. You got some punch, pizzazz, yeah, who and how? All you gotta do is rub that lamp, and I'll say, Mr. Aladdin, sir, what will your pleasure be? Let me take your order, jot it down, you ain't never had a thrill like me. No! Life is your restaurant, and I'm your waiter D. Come on, whisper what it is you want. You ain't never had a friend like me. Yes, sir, we.
Hire sales on the service.
You're the boss, the king, shut up. Say what you wish, it's yours to wish.
I live a baklava. Have some of column A, try all of column B. I'm in the mood to like help you, dude. You ain't never had a friend like me. Here. Can your friends go abracadabra? Little bit, and maybe suck a piece of key. What's my crew, dog?
So sit there, slapped up, buggy, I'm a hit and
smoking and rich. You got me more than a PDA, sir.
I'm gonna take my job to bed.
I got a powerful urge to help you out. So what you wish, I'm gonna need one of
I'm
sorry, Princess. I know all about your little plan to help some poor street urchin, but rules are rules.
He was only trying to help me.
We can't go changing our laws every time the princess gets a whim. What kind of example would that set?
But the boy, what have you done with him? He deserves a fair trial.
I'm sorry to say that the boy has already been, how to put it?
Eaten. By a giant cave. Shaped like a tiger's head. Remember Tok had said, get in my belly.
Dispose, Tok. The regulations are quite clear when it comes to that.
The only man to help.
You have much more important issues to concern yourself with, such as your royal lineage. Your Highness, the Princess and I were just discussing her upcoming marriage. Everything is in order, the feast, the festival. The only thing we seem to be lacking is, well, the groom.
Oh, yes, Jasmine, you must make a decision. And quickly, the people of Agrabah cannot wait forever for their new sultan. I have promised them that you would marry the next eligible suitor who seeks your hand.
They're all egotistical braggarts.
Princess! With all due respect, we can't simply wait around for someone to burst into the palace, blow a trumpet, and announce they found the love of your life. Burst! Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Prince Ali of Avoir, the love of Princess Jasmine's love! Oh, there he is, Bill, coming down the red carpet by Avoir. He's horrible. He's simply a puppy. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to snuggle!
Myself. I am Prince Ali of Avoir! I'm over it. And I would be delighted to ask for your hand in marriage.
OMG. OMG. OMG, Gandalf! Oh,
well, if this isn't the best rose ceremony that I have ever been a part of.
No, Princess, let's not leave your viewers hanging in suspense. What the devil do you think of this fabulousness?
Another fraud.
Ooh, snap, girl, no, you didn't. That's my boy. Don't make me get all TV. Hey, guys, wait. Let's rally and take it from the top. Hey, but at least leave the umbrella. Ella, hey.
I am sorry, Prince Ali. My daughter is a bit selective when it comes to suitors.
Wow. Was there something I said?
Oh, I don't know, Al.
Maybe the parade approach was a bit too Vegas.
Oh, 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 oh. Thank you. Oh, thank you very much. Hey, why don't you go and talk to the princess alone?
Oh, yes, yes, you're right.
Yeah,
go. Genie, you've been such a great help. You deserve something in return. Once the princess falls in love with me, I'll use my last wish to set you free, I promise.
What? You don't mean it. Me! Free. Pinky swear. All right, now you, young sir, go and talk to that lovely Princess Jasmine, and remember, Al, be yourself. It's what's on the inside that counts.
Yeah, well, she certainly isn't going to fall for some street rat.
Hey, you know who else they called a street rat? Ratatouille. You know what he did? A lot!
Don't worry about it, Genie. I know what I'm doing. Come on, girl.
Al, hey, come on. No, I'm being serious. Hey, be yourself, dude! Man! Bro! Bra! Homie! Home slice! Home skillet! Home fries! Home cooking! Home school! Home room! Homework! Home economics! Home on the range! Home alone too! Home town buffet!
I'm gonna go find Nemo.
You're funny!
He's passing himself off as this Prince of Baboon person, but he was supposed to be trapped in the wonder. We might just have to do some shrubbing of our own.
Is this to be my fate? Forced to marry someone who doesn't even know me? But what other choice do I have? Lucky a bird inside a gilded cage. Golden words spoke by an ancient sage. Everything you may have in life, still all you hold is dust. Must I yearn forever to be free? Free to climb a tree and wander, free to wander. There's no desire I won't wander than to be. Simply me. Just a girl with a boy.
to be really free.
Excuse me, Princess. Oh, I don't mean to intrude.
Who granted you permission into my private quarters? Guards? Guards?
No,
you are just like all the rest. You show up with your imperial menagerie and expect me to go weak in the knees? Let me tell you something. Prince Ali, my hand as well as my kingdom can't be bought by some second-rate royal. You're only here to increase your personal wealth and property.
That's not why I'm here.
Oh, I suppose you're in love with me? If you expect me to believe that, you can take a flying leap off my parapet for all I care.
Hey, wait. Very well, Princess. As you wish. Spin on the old carpet. Please. Princess, I don't care about your wealth or your kingdom. I only ask for the chance to get to know you better. What's wrong? Don't you trust me?
Are you sure I don't know you?
Your carpet away is gone. Nice.
princess.
Hey! I found Nemo. Yeah. I don't know, though. That guy is a little fishy. Come on, guys. I had to try it. Just for the hell of it. Hey! How'd it go with Her Majesty?
She's perfect.
Oh, that is great! She likes you, you like her. Oh, and now it's time for my wish.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, I freed you from the cave. That was wish number one. I turned you into a fancy schmancy prince type bro. That was wish number two. And now, all that's left is wish number three, which means it's genie freeing time!
But Jasmine thinks I'm this big, important Prince Ali guy.
I know.
How am I supposed to keep fooling her without you around?
I don't know, but... Hey. Hey, we had a deal, Al.
I know we did, Gina. I'm sorry, I still might need that final wish.
Just like all the rest. Well, I don't know why I let myself get all excited. Well, I mean, I guess I thought you might be the type of guy who would actually, keep his promise.
Hey, Genie.
No.
Please, listen.
No.
Genie, I need
zip it! Zip it real good. Hey, don't worry about me, Master. If you need me, you know where I'll be. Trapped inside my sardine can!
No, Genie! Oh, come on, buddy! You have to understand where I'm coming from. Hey, wait, where are you going? You're not mad at me too, are you? Great. I don't know what I'm doing anymore.
I'll say, cease him! Bring me the Sultan. At last, the kingdom will be mine.
Lucky her, inside gilded cage. Oh, lucky bird, inside gilded cage.
Look, Al, if you've come to apologize, it's too late. But hey, since you're in here, would you mind getting my left shoulder? It is really good. Ah! A man!
I believe you owe me three wishes.
Don't do it, Genie.
Sorry, Al. I've got no choice.
Whoever holds the lamp controls the Genie. It's in the Genie rulebook.
Let us go! How dare you treat the Sultan this way?
Jafar.
He's hypnotized our palace guards.
And I'm afraid we've got bigger pawns than the palace guards.
What do you mean?
Everybody that's got three wishes coming, raise their hand. Oops, looks like it's only me. Genie, my first wish is to rule the kingdom. Make me the Sultan.
There, you're the Sultan. Hey, if your last name was Pepper Shaker, you'd be Sultan Pepper Shaker. I know, right? Hey, zip it. Someone would be like, excuse me, could you pass that? And you'd be like, well, I am the, you know? Oh, yeah, no, I know. I think we all needed that one. Oh. Hey, man, this is
great! You and me, buttons for life, making memories. Oh, like that one time when I was like, hey, if your last name was Pepper Shaker. What's wrong? Did someone serve your coffee in a plain red cup this morning? Oh,
he just got served!
Makes no sense. So are we through here?
We're just getting started. Perhaps merely being insulted isn't enough. For my second wish, I want you to make me the most powerful sorcerer on earth! So to know, my desert blossom, together we shall be unstoppable!
Leave her alone! She doesn't love you and she never will!
You stay out of this, street rat!
Street rat? I thought you were Prince Ali.
I meant to tell you sooner or later.
Prince Ali? Yes, it is he, but not as you know him. Read my lips and come to grips with reality. Yes, we meet our blast from your past, whose lives were too good to last. Say hello to your precious Prince Ali. So Ali turns out to be merely Aladdin. Just a con, need I go on? Take it from me. His personality flaws give me adequate cause to send him packing on a one-way trip, so his prospects take a terminal dip. His assets frozen, the menu chosen, he's the ends of the earth. Whoopee! So long, ex-Prince Ali. But how to eliminate him? Yes, there's only one way to get rid of a street rat.
Power than you'll ever have.
What are you doing?
Trust me. The genie gave you your power and he can take it away.
He's right. For my third and final wish, I want you to make me an all-powerful genie!
Now you've got it, Al. Hocus pocus, snake boy!
Yes! Yes! I can feel the power pulsing through my veins! Aladdin, prepare!
The only problem with being a genie is that you have no freedom. Isn't that right, buddy?
Al, you are a genius. Well, 10,000 years in the Cave of Wonders ought to do him a world of good. Jafar, please keep your hands and feet inside the lamp, and please remain seated at all times. Permanentes tantanos. What's the word? Now for the Tiki Room reject.
Humi, boy, am I glad we got rid of that Jafar, Karen, all the negative energy. Okay, hey there, genie, hey there, buddy, hey, I'm a good guy now, yeah, I'm a whole new bird.
Two words. Yeah. Chicken nuggets.
No, wait. Stop! I suppose we owe our thanks to you, young man.
Father, I think I finally decided on a suit.
You know the truth now. I'm no royal prince.
But you are much better. You are true of the heart. And noble of spirit.
I agree. Besides, who am I to argue with true love?
It's just how it ends on the DVD.
Wow, I am so happy for you, buddy. Hey, we have a wedding to plan. We'll need something old, something new, something borrowed, and something... me.
Was Homer Wish coming?
That, buddy, my wedding present to you. What'll it be?
I wish for your freedom, Jimmy.
This is Jeremy from the Neverland Podcast, and I made a bet there with Jedi Schwa Josh that the AFC Championship would feature the Denver Broncos and the Kansas City Chiefs, and we had a bet that on who the winner would be because he's in Denver and I'm in Kansas City. Well, Denver has beaten Pittsburgh and advanced to the AFC Championship game, and when they march onto the field, they will find KC Chiefs did not show up. And that's what happens when you lose. Kansas City Chiefs didn't even make it. So I'm recording this before the game. So, you know, hopefully for Josh's sake, Denver beats the Patriots and advances to the Super Bowl. And maybe next year the Chiefs will get there. But until then, at least I can enjoy Royals season is coming up very, very soon. Go Royals. Thank you for listening to the Neverland Podcast.
We invite you back next week for more fun and adventure.
Until then, remember to keep a pixie in your pocket.
It's that young at heart, positive attitude that you can share with others.
And remember to visit our website at neverlandpodcast.com.
There you can find links to our news page,
a link to visit our shop,
and much more.
And please feel free to leave us a voicemail at 816-226-6492.
Or email us at podcast@neverlandpodcast.com.
If you email us a Lost Boy
or Pixie
nickname with a reason why you chose that name, you can become an official Neverlander.
Girls are too clever to get lost, so we are naturally magical pixies.
And be sure to follow us on Twitter at NeverlandPcast.
And like our Neverland Podcast fan page on Facebook.
We also have a group on Facebook for you to join.
We also appreciate your support in keeping the Neverland Podcast up and running.
Visit patreon.com/neverlandpodcast to donate to keeping the pixie dust alive.
Copyright content featured on the Neverland Podcast is copyright of their respective creators and used under fair use license.
All original content is copyright of Blue Man Productions. God bless.